My name is Doug Larson. I'm the regional manager for Hortau. This is Jason Kogan. He's a local rep here in Garden. And then Kyle Haggerty, who's also in located in Colorado. So Hortau's been around 15 years. We've been doing this since 2002, actually. We have a little different technology, a little different service. So I'll kind of go into the gist of all that. We'll do a quick overview of an install. Obviously, we pre-drilled some holes so we can just show you kind of what it looks like, give you some ideas. Feel free to ask questions while we're talking, but of course, you're welcome to ask questions after the fact. Something I neglected to mention earlier as well in the last group is that we actually do have a special program through the Kansas Corn Growers Association. So if you're a member of the Kansas Corn Growers, we actually have a special member benefit that we set up specifically for the corn growers. So that's something that you may be interested in as well. So talk a little bit about what we do. A number of things that we do differently. One of them is our measuring device. So we developed and patented our own device. I don't know how many of you might be familiar with soil tension. Soil tension, if you've ever been around the older tensiometers that we used to use, that was my introduction in the soil moisture many years ago. Basically what we've done is we've taken that older technology that we had, the soil tension technology, and we've created our own probe. So instead of having a series, one probe that goes linearly in the profile, we use a series of probes. So typically, whether it was in wheat or corn, we typically plant or install three particular individual probes. The probes are soil tension based, as I mentioned. So as if you can imagine, they still have that ceramic tip that we used on the older tensiometers, the same type of tip. What happens is we fill these with water and we place them in the profile. What's going on then as the tip is, if you think about it in this respect, water can pass through this tip. We're basically measuring how the hydraulic conductivity, or how easily does water move through the profile. Is it hard for the plant to pull water from the profile, or is it easy? That same action that the plant is doing when it's pulling water from soil particles is the same thing that we experience in here. So if it's hard, if it's difficult, the water's not very available for the plant to pull out of the profile, that's exactly what we measure. So when we give, when we develop a graph through this, it's a very good understanding of exactly how available is your water in the profile. Is it easy for the plant to uptake, or is it difficult? So those, since the 50s, we've been pulling that type of data. So we have lots, years and years of good data to give us an idea of exactly where we should be set based on your particular type of soil type. So a number of things. You guys have all probably ran through, you're probably about probed out at this point in time. You've heard probably more than you need to know about probes today. But that's one of the differences of what ours do. The other thing is, because each one of these probes is an individual independent probe, we can place them at different places in the profile. So for example, generally in corn, we'll talk about wheat. So in a wheat installation like this, we would typically have three individual probes. We would place the first one at 8, then at 16, and then at 24 for wheat. But then if we were in a corn installation, we'd typically be at 8, 18, and 30 inch depths, or at other depths. Once in a while, we'll have somebody who wants them at every foot lateral, and we can do that, of course. It's not uncommon even for somebody to take and use these probes in wheat in the spring, in irrigated wheat. We'll put them in at those depths, and then we'll switch them over, put them in the corn later in the year, move them in the corn maybe late June or maybe late May, and start measuring the profile in corn. So a couple other things. Because these are independent, one of the other items, I don't know if we have anybody here that has drip systems or not. I know there are a few down here in Kansas in the region. But if you're in a drip tape situation, where we have 5 foot laterals is typically what people are down in this country are doing with their SDI, their buried drip tape. So most of them are 5 foot laterals. Right now, unless you put your other probe right in the middle of your 2 5-foot laterals, you have no real concept or no real way of seeing what kind of lateral movement you're getting from your profile. But one of the things that we can do, because these are each individual, we can actually place a number of probes. This piece of equipment will actually hold 4 probes, but we have larger where we can put a great number of probes in the ground if we need to. But we can now add, so say that we have this one at 8 inches near the tape, but we could also put one at 8 inches or 18 inches or 30 inches far away from the tape, so we can see, are we pushing that water laterally? So if I want to plant in an orientation different than going with the row, can I do that and still get good push of water through the profile? So we can check that. So normally what would happen then is we would use an auger bit, drill the hole or do it manually depending on the situation. Sometimes we'll go in the fields that are too hard to even do that, so we'll do it manually. We would pre-drill holes one at a time, and then as we do that, we'll go in and actually use, we have another probe. So this will actually pull the final piece of the profile out for us, so that when we place this in, it basically, if you think about it, those are very similar to each other. So it makes a really nice tight fit as we go into the hole. We have a real nice tight fit that we can seal into. One of the nice parts about that is that we don't change the profile. When we place the probe in, the profile is in its natural environment. We're putting it right in the native soil as it was, so we can evaluate exactly what's going on. So in this situation, normally what we'll do, as Jason's going to do, we'll put a little bit of water in the profile, because remember, this has water in it, and it's going to measure it, that movement of water through the profile. What Jason's doing now is this would be as we're setting it in a normal situation. Then he's also going to set that. So now we've applied water, so we get a real nice tight fit, so we've got a good seal. And then he's placed it in the profile as well. And then what would happen is he'd do the same thing on the deeper probe, and then we would pack in the soil around it to make sure that we don't get any preferential flow down into that hole. So that gives you a good understanding of what that looks like. Then what takes place once we've done this, obviously we would bury all the leads just as we've done on the other system over here to the right or to your left. So basically what's above ground, once the system is going, this is what you would see in a normal situation in the field, whether it be corn, wheat, or whatever, or vegetable production for that matter. All of these leads would tie in, they'd be buried, they'd all tie into the base unit, and then every 15 minutes we're sending a signal out. So everything's uploaded to the web in real time. So when we build our graphs, and we can show you our graphs here in a moment, but when we build our graphs, they're based on exact time. So every 15 minutes. So when we start looking at those graphs, you can see that they're very representative of what's happening in real time. And we always talk about real time with what we do, and that's really a key about it. So if we see that a farmer is putting on more water than he needs to, or that there's not enough deep moisture, we can help him plan for that. Generally, if he can put on less water, we can help for that. Generally, what we'll find is the majority of our clients will come back to us and say, oh yeah, I'm saving enough energy and pumping costs to pay for my equipment. So a couple things about what we do. So you understand what it looks like when we put it in the field. Generally, if this were corn plants, the corn plants would be right to the side of it. We can put them right between the corn plant, but we found over time, if there is any maintenance issue that somebody needs to be done, or if for some reason, if you notice the second one that Jason put in had a longer tube on it, that's a fill tube, so we can keep adding water for the deeper probes. Generally, we don't have to add water during the season. It's something we do at the beginning when we place the probes in. But if we're in a deficit irrigation situation, once in a while we'll have one run out in a live situation like this. And that's part of what we do. So our goal is to help you guys learn what's going on in the field in real time. But we don't want to just get you equipment and we're down the road. So what happens is when we put systems in, we actually install the systems ourselves. We pull them out in the fall ourselves. We train you and your team, whoever's on your team, whoever you wish to have trained, even an agronomist. If you've gone agronomist many times, and we hear this all the time, we hear that we're supposed to be competitors with agronomists, but we're on the same team. So we've trained lots of agronomists over the years to help them understand exactly what our equipment is doing. They still come out and do their weekly activities in the field, and that's great. But now they can correlate those with what we're doing as well, so we can enhance what they're doing. Say if it rains 2 inches, your agronomist was out yesterday, it rains 2 inches tomorrow. So where's that put his recommendation? So we can help with that. So the recommendation typically for us is that we actually give the agronomist his own password so he can go on to your site and see what's going on. But all the site, all the pages are, it's all your data. It's all password protected. If you have other people in your operation that you want to have access through a different password, then of course we set up a password for them as well, so that we can track what they do as well. You can set up passwords that people can get on, but they don't actually have, they only have viewing capabilities. And oops, Look at that, coming unhooked. So that's a real common situation for us to find. But the key is we want to help you throughout the season. So not only do we train you, but after we train you throughout the season, we'll go through and give you assistance, typically on a weekly basis. If that's what the farmer wants, we'll contact them and let them know what we're seeing in the profile. Okay, are we seeing that we're getting way too dry? Are we seeing that we're way too wet? Can we space it out, our irrigations, a little bit more, and help them refine the irrigation situation? As I mentioned, oftentimes what we'll find is we'll save guys a couple inches a year depending on their current practices, and that relates into enough energy savings typically to pay for their systems as well. Then what happens is, so this uploads to the cloud. Through that, some people like to go on and pull up their app so they can pull it up on their smartphone and see everything there. Of course, we have a specific app for that. You can even though you're not a client, you can go, at this point, you can go on and download that off Google Play or whatever. I guess if you use Apple, you wouldn't go there. But anyways, you can pull it up and pull up that app if you choose to. Then what happens is it uploads. I don't know how well you guys can see the TV screen, but if you look on there, you can actually see a big blue line right through the middle of our graph. What happens is each of these is graphed out individually. So we can select or deselect any one of these probes that we choose to at a particular time, or we can have them all represented at the same time, and then we watch them through that blue zone, or what we would call a comfort zone, based on years of research of knowing when too much water affects yield and too little of water affects yield. We create this optimum range, and we adjust that based on soil type. Our probes don't, there's no calibration to soil tension. True soil tension is a true representation of what's happening in the profile. Where we do adjust it is we adjust based on soil type. So we move your blue zone specifically for your soil type situation. But that's the gist of how those will work. And then we have people that go on a daily basis, hourly basis. We can look on them on the full season, or we can narrow it down to look at it on a minute-by-minute basis if that's what we wish to do. So say, for example, you had a big rain event and you want to see how long it took for that rain event or your irrigation to get down to each particular part of the profile. We can track down within 15 minutes, we can track down exactly how long it took to get through each part of the profile throughout that time. Anything else? But that's basically what we do. We pride ourselves on the service side of what we're doing and the soil tension side. So it's very different from what some of the other technologies that are out there, but we're all about soil tension for us, or what's available in the profile for you. Very good? But if you have questions, feel free to ask. In a corn situation, so you're aware, this is more typical of what we would do, obviously, in low canopy stuff. But in corn, we would normally raise these up to about 5 foot. The base unit would still stay down this high, but we raise the post up to about 5 foot tall. About 8 foot tall, so we can kind of get above canopy just a little bit. We can set that up in a way that if you're, I see some now going, oh man, I'm going to spray and hit that. But oftentimes we'll have these set low in the beginning part of the season, and so you can spray over the top of them, and then we'll raise them up after you're done. Say June 15, when you're done spraying, we would raise these up and make them tall at that point in time. Basically, we can set them in any part of the field. With GPS nowadays, we can put them on guest rows, whatever the case may be, as well. But that's pretty common of what we set up. We can put it. We also have, of course, not only this, but we also do things like soil temperature. We can obviously have full weather stations. We do actually have telemetry that we put onto flow meters as well, so we can tie all that in if you wish to. We're actually right in the cusp of breaking out with a product for controlling pivot as well. So we're working on that as well. But lots of different pieces that we do. Any questions? You can ask questions or come back later if you wish. All right. Well, thank you very much.